Greetings from the Boogie Down Bronx. My name is Jeffrey Cortez. I'm going to read the first chapter of my quirky novel entitled Memoirs of Pastor Rajatabla, Pentecostal Private Eye. In the description here, I have a prefix and the rationale behind this quirky a novel that I wrote recently. All right, so I'm going to read the first chapter. And in summary, just to give you a key to this particular novel, this is a Pentecostal, a pastor, clinically trained in residing in an urban area and pastoring a small Spanish Pentecostal storefront church. His nickname is Raja, and he has members of the community and other congregations of small branches of the Spanish Pentecostal movement come to him with their concerns and regarding rumors or real events or gossips. So they come to him to help them resolve this issue that comes up. So Raja investigates, and then he writes a journal, and his journal, and which he's nicknamed Tabla. So the little side joke there is Raja Tabla. Raja is the pastor, and Tabla is his journal. Whenever he writes in this journal in the book, you'll see that is in italics. All right, so the first chapter is entitled More Than Pigeon Feeding. And the scripture I put there is, do not rebuke an elder man harshly, but exhort him as if he were your father. Sister Bienvenida called Raja and informed him of her concern about an elderly couple at her church. Raja would have politely told her that it was very late. He was tired from a long work day, but shied away from asking her to call the next day. Now, this particular late night caller had pioneered and founded a well-known large Pentecostal church. She did this at a time where there was much strong opposition to Pentecostalism by local society and historical churches. For decades, she mentored well-known missionaries, evangelists, and church planters. In the past, Raja himself had the privilege to sit in her Tuesday night prayer / Bible studies. She spoke of her firsthand experience of being harassed and insulted in front of her storefront church. One amazing story she told was of incidences where people threw vegetables at her and at her Bible students during street meetings. She then collected the thrown produce and later made delicious stews out of the unkind contributions. It was rumored that once a week, Sister Bienvenida would purposely go to a farmer's market in the Bronx, Little Italy area, where she was also veggie assaulted. These would end up being a source of large pots of stew cooked for a soup kitchen ministry she founded. Anyways, Bienvenida suspected that an elderly newlywed husband, Brother Paco, from her church was suicidal. A former church member who lived next door to Paco and wife Juanita had overheard a disturbing conversation and conveyed it to Bienvenida. This reportedly then communicated to the couple's young pastor, Reverend Nico, who in turn reportedly became annoyed and dismissed the urgency of having an intervention conducted. As per other church members, the elderly pair hadn't been attending religious services for a couple of weeks. Raja added this mystery to a list of items he would pray about, seeking the Lord's guidance. One afternoon, Raja was enjoying a window shopping walk downtown on one of his mental health days. He stopped momentarily by a Victoria's Secret store, looking at their window display and humorously pondering what to get his supportive wife, Tesoro, for Valentine's Day. An older couple came out from the store and immediately recognized him, calling him by name. Embarrassed, he greeted them and apologized for not remembering them. They did not know him personally and just remembered him as a guest speaker at their church some time ago. They introduced themselves as Paco and Juanita. It turned out they had decided to reserve a Midtown hotel room a couple of weeks ago to enjoy the city's free events and delicious soup kitchens as a secret getaway extended honeymoon. They giggled as Raja told them about their community's concerns over their absence. Paco and Juanita then filled in essential details. Dear Tabla, the newly married couple, Paco and Juanita, fed birds as one of their activities. Their young pastor strongly recommended instead of making love. Previously, during their pastoral premarital counseling, it was found out that the male senior had a very serious heart condition. Their young pastor warned them that if Paco had sex, he would most certainly die. So after a wonderful wedding, they had the daily routine of eating three simple healthy meals, listening to soft music, feeding birds in the park, and each going to their separate bedrooms at night. This went on for 2 weeks. One night, there was a knock on Juanita's bedroom door. She quickly put on her night robe and asked Paco what he wanted. He answered, "Me quiero morir." I want to die. That night, ignoring their pastor's warning, that night was full of ecstatic hallelujahs, as well as other miraculous nights, mornings, and afternoons. Thank goodness the ill-informed pastoral guidance they received didn't fully kick in. As I related my findings to Elder Bienvenida and the couple's young pastor, Reverend Nico, they were at first stoic, then laughed hysterically. They agreed to keep lines of communication open. The pastor conceded that he needed to be less dogmatic and ignorant when counseling aging congregants. Bienvenida interjected, especially married horny ones. That's the end of chapter 1.